Thank you for watching T&L Food Channel. The holidays are behind us, and as people that have a YouTube cooking channel, we got a bunch of new cooking things to try for Christmas. So tonight we're going to try out our new electric skillet. This is a Copper Chef removable deep dish electric skillet. It says you can boil, simmer, saute, steam, fry right on the copper the countertop. Comes with an electric base that you can plug in with a thermostat and a glass lid. So we're going to go ahead and give it a shot. We're going to open it up. It comes with a little recipe book, and we'll see what all's inside here. Maybe the unboxing is a little bit harder than I thought it was going to be.
Well.
Darn styrofoam. There we go.
Careful, it's going to fall.
There's a nice glass lid. It says Copper Chef right on it. It's got a little hole for your steam while you're frying. Alright, we're gonna go ahead and take the pan out of the plastic. Here's the little recipe book that comes with it. Looks like some pork chops or steaks there on the front of it. Nice thick cookbook. Open it up. There's some recipes, your owner's guide, how to use your skillet and everything's in there. Go ahead and set all that aside. Nice, deep copper chef skillet. It's got some fancy design there on the bottom. Nice silver handles to take it on and off the hot plate. Cooking surface. The pan itself, it's got a nice silver thing, it says caution hot surface on it. It's where you're going to plug in your temperature control and just put that right on the counter. Where is the the temperature control? It's got some different temps on it. Looks like it can go up to 425 degrees. It's got a warm button, a zero button, and it's a little turn dial. Turn it to the temperature that you're going to want it at. And you just plug it right in here. Just like that. I'm going to go ahead and unscrew out the tie here. Not a very long cord. So make sure you have enough room to plug it in. Pop it right there. And turn it this way so that I have easy access to the pan. And then when you're cooking, you just put that right on there like that. And cover it up. Now we're gonna go ahead and work on getting dinner ready, and we're going to show you how it works. I'm back. I wanted to point out a couple more things about the pan that we did notice. When you put it on the base has a little groove here. I don't know if you can see that, but there's a little lip and that lip fits right into the bottom of the lip of the pan here. So you actually, when you put it on there, it locks in there. That's kind of nice. And then when you set the temperature, I'm gonna put it on zero here because it is warming up a little bit. If you don't want it to warm up, make sure it's on zero. You wanna make sure the temp is lined up with the little arrow there on the control. And then I also wanted to point out on the box that not only can you use it on the bottom of the base as a skillet, it also can work as a buffet server. You can cook with it on the stovetop or in the oven. So it's a pretty versatile and pretty useful little pan.
So that's all I'm gonna say about the pan at the moment.
There is some little bit of cooking charts inside the user's guide as well. Care and maintenance, troubleshooting, lots of useful information in there. I'm back to mention a couple more things about our pan as we're starting to use it that we've noticed.
Put some oil in it.
We did put some oil in it. We did notice that when the oil is heating up, there is right here, the arrow does light up as an indicator light to let you know that it is heating. It did mention in the user's manual to preheat it, at least especially the first time before you use it, so we are doing that. During the preheating, we noticed that the silver base doesn't get that warm.
At least on the sides.
On the sides, at least here. Yeah, all the way around. Doesn't seem to be getting warm on the sides. The copper pot, though, whew, it does get warm. There's also a memo in here to make sure, you know, when you're done cooking, your handles may get hot. So beware of that. A couple other things I did notice.
Use a hot pad and be safe.
Yep. Use a hot pad and be safe. It specifically says use silicone or plastic tongs when removing food. So I do have some silicone tongs here that I will be using to remove the food. These are, they're Tasty. Tasty brand silicone tongs. Another thing I did want to mention is, it says when you're done using it and you want to clean it, make sure you let it cool down at least half an hour before you do try to clean the appliance.
So eat first.
Yeah, eat first. Don't just jump right into your cleanup. And then the one last thing I feel is probably worth mentioning, we had mentioned that the box said this was oven safe. I cannot find anything in the book, just glancing through it, as far as the temperature of the oven. So that might be something to be mindful of, and make sure you do some research if you do try to use the pan in the oven. Let's see how many we can get in there. I'm kind of putting them in kind of haphazardly, no real rhyme or reason, but it's a very big pan, guys. I have completed these steak strips. As you can see, we have a huge plate here. We got quite a few. There's some really tiny ones, some bigger ones. So now we're going to plate up the rest of our dinner and go ahead and have a bite to eat. Okay, so for Christmas, we jumped on the bandwagon and bought a bunch of Copper Chef pans. A few days ago, we did a video of cooking in one of our Copper Chef pans, this electric skillet we have right here. We made some steak strips in it, and we figured since we used just oil, we wanted to do another quick video where we showed a little bit of cleanup of how easy the Copper Chef pans are to clean up, because that's part of the appeal of the Copper Chef pans. And as you can see, I have another, 12-inch skillet?
12-inch skillet, yep.
12-inch skillet here. Last night we did make some fajitas, and you can see a little bit of the vegetables stuck in the pan. So again, we're trying to make it to where you can see how easy it is to clean up. As you can see with my finger, I can just
moving around. It hasn't even been in any water yet. Evidently did not stick to the pan too much. Copper Chef did stand up against the vegetables. Same thing here with the skillet. I made a scrambled egg cheese skillet this morning. Tried my best to get the eggs and cheese to burn onto the pan to try and give it a good run for its money and clean up. As you can see again, the pan defeated me. It just rubs right off. So in our book, so far, we definitely say Copper Chef is going to be very easy cleanup. They were very easy to use. Very lightweight pans. That 12-inch skillet is just so simple to lift. Very lightweight. Tom's gonna give it a scrub here really quick.
A little bit of residue sticking on, but as you can see, it is wiping right off with the soapy water. It's not a scrub at all. So as you can see, all the pieces are off now. So just clean it up real good.
So that kind of concludes our review of our Copper Chef electric skillet with base and the 12-inch pan. Look forward to more videos from us, and thanks for watching.
Let them see the end here.
Oh, sorry, let me.
Even the water doesn't want to stick to it, it runs right off.
It's beating up and everything. I don't know if you can see that, but.
They do appear to be great pans. They do appear to do what is promised of them. You know, they do tend to work really good.
And I think I really like how lightweight they are. So.
Yes, they are extremely lightweight. So.
Give them a try and enjoy.